Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to challenge you. I want to give you some homework. And you've probably already seen the title slide, so you know what that's about. This is to auto all the things. Now, my job, if you will, if you were to say that I have a job here on C++ Weekly and on this YouTube channel and the conference talks and the training and everything that I do in the C++ community, it is not so much that I am always teaching best practices or that I am always showing you the right way to do things. I mostly want to make you think. And that's a large part of what my C++ best practices book is about. I give you specific exercises to try and to do. And that's what I'm going to make this episode about as well. Now, what I want you to do as an educational process, this is not a best practice. I'm not saying this is the way you should write all of your code. I'm saying this is something to do to experiment and learn more about the language. So this is your C++ homework, and that is to auto all the things. Now, I had this example up already from the episode that I recorded on constraining auto here, just so that you can see it. We can constrain auto with concepts, and that is going to be allowed in this exercise. It doesn't have to be just auto everywhere. But I want you to start with a project and literally make everything auto that you can. All of the return types, all of the function parameters, all of the objects, make them all auto. So I'm going to start with this simple example. I'm not going to do a full complete auto example here, but I'm going to show you what I mean. So for the sake of having a small accessible project, here is the small PT global illumination and 99 lines of C++ code. It's a little generous to say that this is actually 99 lines, and I'll show you why in a minute. But the idea is that you've got this tiny little ray tracer. It's this long. It is in 99 lines of code, less than 100 lines of code. It has got a lot of inconsistencies in it. And this little bit of extra OpenMP pragma parallel thing in here that you could remove. But if you were to take this, and there is a link here for the plain text version of it. There's also a even smaller version of it. Let's ignore that one from now. You can take this and you can copy this right into Compiler Explorer, and it can actually run the program. Now, I've got my dash W error enabled, and this code is definitely going to generate some warnings. We definitely want to leave W all, W extra, and double W conversion on. There we go. It just ran the program, and it manages to complete about 33% of the render in Compiler Explorer before it times out. You can get rid of this pragma if you want to, but you can take any project you have. If you've got your own project, that's fine. Or you can take this project and just go through and say, what can I make auto? Can I make everything auto? For example, can I make our member variables auto? Spoiler alert, no, you can't. Non-static data members cannot be declared auto. What happens if I make the constructor for VEC take auto parameters? Is that going to succeed or fail, and why and in what ways? So what are the limitations that you're going to reach? Does it make sense to say that I can add anything? I want to make this an auto on the plus side, right-hand side of this plus operator. Probably not. But that's for you to figure out while you're doing this exercise. You can start from this example, or you can start from your own. How much of these things do you want to constrain? How much of them do you want to say, oh, yes, this is auto, but it must be something that contains an X, Y, and a Z member? Maybe that would be something that you would do, and you can make your own concept for that. And you can do that throughout this. I mean, it probably makes a ton of sense to make clamp be something that just takes an auto. To int, that, why does that have to be a double? Maybe that could be, you know, any floating point. Whatever. Go through either this project or another project, find the limitations of using auto everywhere. And so that is your first C++ homework assignment. And this will teach you a lot about using auto, about type coercion, about type deduction, and about type constraining in C++ 20. If you take it to that point of writing your own concepts so you can constrain these auto things that are being passed around. And it also could be interesting to see, does your output change compared to the baseline one? Do you see a difference in the actual compiled binary here? Definitely interesting things to learn. So I hope that you find this fun. Feel free to comment on this in the video here. And if you've got any examples that you would like to share, then submit a pull request to add your example of autoing everything, either for this program or for another, on the official C++ weekly GitHub repository, and I'll try to make a collection point for everyone's auto all of the things examples, and feel free to document it and say what you learned during this process. Now, I am currently planning 3 more of these C++ homework assignments. Oh, one more thing, and now I know from looking at my YouTube stats that about 50% of you have already stopped watching this episode, but it is really worth noting that this is 98 lines here. If I just do this format document shift alt F, it's 147 lines, and you get so much more readable code because it just applied a Clang format here. So, you know, you probably shouldn't have already stopped watching, because that's a handy little tidbit to know about. Well, be sure to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and let me know what you thought of this one.